to give you few questions to start with. So the first one, our religion name Islam. What that means? And the second question, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about Ibrahim alayhi salam, and he said, إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was a Muslim, but again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him to surrender, and then Ibrahim replied, I surrender my will to you, my Lord. So why Allah asked him again? And then when Ibrahim alayhi salam intend to slaughter his son, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, at this moment, فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ. Again, here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they both surrender. So why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again he mentioned it. So here, few questions to reflect upon when we study this beautiful name of Allah. So the meaning of Al-Qahir, the one who take over things, the one that everything is humble to him, the one who take control of everything. So when we say Al-Qahhar, so that the first one is Al-Qahir, the one who control everything, the one that everything is humble to him. So Al-Qahhar, that one means that regardless how much strong those things, he also make them humble to him, and he control them. How much big, how much strong they are, how many they are, still they are under his control. He's taking over things. So how much the power it was, how many powers are there, all these powers, they are humble to his will. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. Our beloved mother Aisha radiyallahu anha, she asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, when the earth will be changed, and the earth as well, where are the people going to be? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they are going to be on الصراط المستقيم, on the straight path, on the top of hellfire. So here, on that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَوْمَهُمْ بَارِزُونَ لَا يَخْفَى على الله منهم شيء. On that day, everything is exposed. You cannot hide anything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah will ask, لمن الملك اليوم? Who is the king today? And Allah replied to himself, لله الواحد القهار. It is obvious, always the power and the king belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But why Allah again asked that question? Even in dunya, everything belongs to him. But some people who don't have this faith, who don't have this belief, they think that the power is in the hands of someone or in the hands of some country. But as a matter of fact, everything, everyone, he cannot act, he cannot do anything without Allah will, without Allah permission. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in one verse, وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ مَا فَعَلُوا. If Allah wants, they will never do it. So when you think about it, so many questions comes up to your mind. Why this is happening here? Why such things happening there? Why this calamity here? Keep in mind, وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ مَا فَعَلُوا. If Allah wants, nothing of that will happen. But He wants these things to happen because of His wisdom. And now, here, there is a beautiful meaning. وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ. He is the one in power over everything, not by because of arrogance, حاشا لله, no way, but because وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ. Two things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is controlling everything on earth or in heaven. Two things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use, that is His experience and His wisdom. So because of the experience and the wisdom He has subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's why He drives everything and make the things happen according to His wisdom, at the proper time, at the proper place, whenever He wants. So when we think about, for example, Pharaoh, the superpower on earth at that time, he used to call people to worship him. No one can resist. Everyone under his feet. And when Musa alayhi salam came to him, then he asked Musa, don't you see, أَلَيْسَ لِي مُلْكُ مِصْرَ, I own Egypt, وَهَذِهِ الْأَنْهَارُ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِي, and those rivers flowing under my feet. Look how much arrogant he was. And what Allah's action was, He made him to sink and to be drawn in the sea, right? He said, the water and the river flowing under my feet, Allah make it to flow on the top of his head. And he sank and drowned. This is one meaning of Al-Qahhar. Al-Qahhar. Nothing can resist his will. No one can resist his will. An-Namrud, one very famous emperor, he is the one who decided to throw Ibrahim alayhi salam in the fire. What happened to him? He was so arrogant, so arrogant. But Allah punished him in a very neglected insect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered a fly while he was sleeping to go through his nose and go into his brain cover. So it goes into his head and it keeps flying and making noise until he becomes so mad, and it will not stop until he asks his servants to hit his head with their shoes. Look what punishment Allah gave him. And they keep hitting him with their shoes on his head until the fly stopped, and so on. So no one can resist Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one can challenge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I mentioned the story of the Titanic. Everyone, they make it a very romantic story, while it is a non-romantic story. It's a challenge for Allah. They build one very strong ship, cruise, and they said it will never sink because they make it double walls. If the first wall will get crack, then they are able to use the partitions to close that portion and the ship will survive. Yes, and they said even fate will never stop this ship. That is what they declare in the newspaper. And they call the most richest people to come to do the first trip from Europe to America. The first trip, it hit an ice mountain and the ship goes into two pieces and sink. No one can challenge Allah's will. No one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ وَهِيَ دُخَانِ. When the heaven was just a smoke, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called heaven and earth. فقال لها وللأرض ائتيا طوعا أو كرها. Come to me by force or by your will. قالتا أتينا طائعين. Both they said, we are humble, we obey you. When Musa عليه السلام heard this verse, he asked Allah, oh Allah, what if they refuse? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Musa, I will bring another creature to make him swallow both heaven and earth. No one can resist. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلِلَّهِ يَسْجُدُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ طَوْعًا أَوْ كَرْهًا. Means everyone in heaven and on earth will prostrate to Allah by his will or by force. You cannot go out from this line. No one can escape. No one can do anything. All the creatures, they are humble and they obey the rules of Allah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the mankind and the jinn the choice. Which way you like, you can choose. You want to obey or you want to disobey. And you are responsible for your choice. You are responsible. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who said, kun fayakun, he is also able to say, zul fayazul. The one who said, be, and it is done, he is able to say, vanish, and it is gone. Very simple. Very simple. He can do it. Look to the previous, the perished nations. Which one survive? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَالشَّمْسُ يَنْبَغِي لَهَا أَن تُدْرِكَ الْقَمَرِ. So even the sun cannot move together with the moon. Everyone has its own orbit. Each one of the orbits has its own circle. No one can move away. Allah put a line from the time zero when He created everything until the day of judgment. Everyone will follow. No one will change. They have to pass through the same line to continue this life. وَاللَّهُ يَحْكُمُ لَا مُعَقِّبَ لِحُكْمِهِ. When Allah did His judgment, no one can ask Him why. لَا يُسْأَلُ عَمَّا يَفْعَلُ وَهُمْ يُسْأَلُونَ. He is not questionable, but we are, yes, questionable. We are the one who will be questioned, but no one will question Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ. So we cannot do anything without His will, without His permission. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن تَوَلَّيْتُمْ, and if you deny, فَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّكُمْ غَيْرُ مُعْجِزِ اللَّهِ. Then you know that you are not making trouble to Allah, you are making trouble to yourself. If you deny, you are making trouble but to yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rules is valid and in force in all heaven and earth. So the aspects of His force, of His power, for example, the night and the days, the night and the daylight, there is no way that you can have 24 hours day and then 12 hours night. There is no way. There is no way that the sun will not shine up until that day when He wants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the rain to fill in a drops of water while it is flying on the top of all cities in a clouds, while the cloud weight is 100 tons. It carry a lot of water. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He make the water to rain in a drops so that it will be safe on us and on the plants. Allah also capable to make the water to drop all together one time 300, 400 tons to come down. And then you imagine what will happen. That is Al-Qahhar. Al-Qahhar, he make the water something incredible. The water is combined from hydrogen and oxygen. The hydrogen is flammable, and the oxygen needed for the flame. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Qahhar, he joined them together, he combined them together to make water to shut off the flame. The hydrogen is flammable. The oxygen increased the flame. Allah combined them together to make water to shut off the flame. You see the meaning of Al-Qahhar? He joined two things like ourselves. We are made from mud, while our souls come from heaven, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He make this body, which is made of mud, to contain that soul which comes from the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And without this soul, we cannot live. And he make this soul to go into every atom in our body. If any piece of our body lost the soul, that piece will die. This is Al-Qahhar. He joined two opposite things together to make a new different thing out of it. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in one very important hadith. He said, O son of Adam, you wish something, and I wish another thing. If you surrender your wish to my wish, I will make what you wish to happen. But if you do not surrender your wish to my wish, I will make it hard on you, and then what is my wish is going to happen. My wish is going to happen. So we cannot resist the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we just go back to the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he dreamed that he is slaughtering his own son, his beloved son. Ibrahim was 90 years plus, and he was only one son. When his son became young and he became more close to his father, he saw a dream that he is slaughtering his own son. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not send Jibreel alayhi salam with a very straightforward order, slaughter your son. No, he make it just a dream to see what Ibrahim will say. Then Ibrahim, he knows that the dream of a prophet is a true. Then Ibrahim alayhi salam, he wants his son to share in the reward, and he wants to test his son as well. So he said to his son, my son, I saw in my dream that I am slaughtering you. Then his son Ismail alayhi salam said, Ya abati, if'al ma tu'mar, satajiduni insha'allahu min as-sabirin. Oh my father, do what you have ordered to do. I am, inshallah, will be patient. Ibrahim don't know why and what is the wisdom behind this order, but he obey. Then when he got his son told him, my dad, sharpen your knife to make the cut easy. So he sharpened the knife. When he went to slaughter him, Ismail said, my dad, let my face to be down, not up, so that you will not feel mercy on me. You just obey the order. So he turned his face to the ground and Ibrahim put the blade on his neck. At this time, he started cutting with the sharp blade, but the cut did not happen. This is Al-Qahhar. The sharp did not cut. The fire of Ibrahim did not burn. This is Al-Qahhar. He changed the statistics of everything. He changed the characteristics of everything according to his will. The one which is burning, it's no more burning. The one which is cutting is no more cutting. At this moment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا. So now both, Ibrahim and his son, they both surrender to Allah's will. This is your will, and we surrender our will to your will. فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ وَنَادَيْنَاهُ أَنْ يَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا. At this moment, O Ibrahim, you did what you have been asked for. إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْحَقُّ الْمُبِينَ. This is the true. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants everyone from us to react, to surrender our will to Allah's will. You know, every one of us have seen or visited Al-Bayt Al-Haram. When you perform Umrah or Hajj, when you do the Tawaf, why you are making Tawaf around Al-Kaaba? Why 7 strokes? Why not 10? When we go between As-Safa and Al-Marwa, why we go all this stroke? Going, coming. And in a certain portion, we have to jog. And why it is 7? All of this, it is giving you one conclusion. We have to obey. We surrender our will to Allah's will. This is the way Allah wants it to be. We have to do it like what Allah wants it to be. We cannot challenge. We cannot argue. We cannot. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ما كان للمؤمنين الخيرة في أمرهم إذا قضى الله ورسوله أمرا. Means when Allah and Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, they decided something, we have nothing to argue. No way. So what we need to understand from this name, we need to build some kind of, we call it haiba, means fear mixed with love towards Allah. When we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is capable to change, is capable to do anything, we have to respect his will. We have to follow his rules. We have to obey him subhanahu wa ta'ala. I have 2 stories here to tell you about, and then inshallah we'll close by them. First story about Amir al-Mu'mineen al-Ma'mun. Al-Ma'mun, he is the son of Abdul Malik ibn Marwan. So Al-Ma'mun, on his time, there was some corruption. So he ordered to capture those people and put them in jail. So when they captured them, his minister came to him and he told him, this man which you want him by name, he's in your prison. So Al-Ma'mun said, by Allah, I will cross him. So he wrote a letter to his servant, the one who is in charge for the prison, to crucify this person. So when that letter goes to the prison keeper, so he released him. Then the minister came back and he told him that the prison guards, they released that fellow. Then he called him, why you release him? He said, you send me a letter to release him. He said, no, I send you a letter to cross him, to crucify him. He said, no, this is the letter. So he checked. Instead of writing release, instead of writing crucify, he wrote release. Then he teared that paper and he wrote another one. This fellow to be crucified. And he gave it to the guards. The guards look again. It is written released. Then he said, okay, I will write another one. So he teared that paper and he wrote on the paper, by Allah, he is going to be crucified. And he gave to the guards. The guards took the letter and read, it is written, by Allah, he is going to be released. They said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, you wrote it wrong. He said, by Allah, if Allah wants to release him, I have nothing to do to crucify him. Let him to be released. In Arabic, he wrote, he said, Wallahi la yuslaban. When he wrote it, he wrote, Wallahi la yutlaqan. Keep in mind what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Wallahu yahulu baynal mar'i wa qalbih. Means Allah can resist your heart to follow your mind. Allah is able to make your heart not to follow your minds. And the other story about one doctor in the university. He is teaching philosophy and he was kafir. He is teaching his student kufr. He do not believe in God, do not believe in any religion. So he has one daughter, 5 years old. She got fever and her temperature become 41. He took her to the doctors and then to the specialists. They told him, this is a very rare case. It happens one per every 10 million. There is no cure. We don't know what to do. They used cold patch, water, whatever, nothing. They told him, if the temperature will stay like that, your daughter will pass away. So he started bringing his daughter to his lectures in the university. And when he see her, he cried until he gave up. He gave up. His wife told, she entered his room and she found him making sujood, prostrate and cry. And she hear what he's saying. He said, oh God, people, they said that you are there. If you are there, please either heal her or take me and her to you. So you have two options with this name, Al-Qahhar. Two options. Either you follow by your will or you follow by force. Which one you like? You follow Allah rules by your will or you follow Allah rules by force. You cannot resist. You don't have the power to resist. Whom you are to resist. والحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم اجمعنا على ما يرضيك واجعلنا من المتحابين فيك. اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مباركا مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده معصوما، ولا تجعل منا ولا فينا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم أصلح أحوالنا وبلغنا مما يرضيك آمالنا، واختم بالصالحات أعمالنا وبالسعادة آجالنا، وتوفنا وأنت راض عنا. اللهم إنا نسألك من كل خير سألك منه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ونعوذ بك من كل شر استعاذك منه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. اللهم إنا نسألك صحبة حبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم قد حرمنا صحبته في الدنيا، فلا تحرمنا إياها في الآخرة يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم اجعلنا ممن تقول لهم في نهاية هذا المطاف يا أرحم الراحمين قل لنا قوموا قد غفرت لكم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم إنا نسألك رحمة من عندك تهدي بها قلوبنا وتغفر بها ذنوبنا، اللهم وتجمع بها شملنا وتلم بها شعثنا وتصلح بها أمرنا. اللهم لا تجعل لنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا همّا إلا فرجته، ولا عيبا إلا سترته، ولا مريضا إلا شافيته، ولا غائبا إلا لأهله سالما رددته يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم آتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.